टुडे प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर मनोज कुमार विल गिव लेक्चर एंड डिस्कशन ऑन द एनआईआरएफ। एनआईआरएफ नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशनल रैंकिंग फ्रेमवर्क, ए मेथोडोलॉजी फॉर द रैंकिंग ऑफ द यूनिवर्सिटी एंड कॉलेजेज इन इंडिया। This NIRF is done by the Department of the Higher Education, Ministry of Human Resources Development, Government of India, and how the ranking of university and colleges in India is done. This is the guideline for the NIRF. The table of the contents for the NIRF is the forward, preface, composition of the committee of the National Institutional Ranking Framework, UGC notification, cum meeting notice, executive summary, silent feature, ranking based on the institutional category, data collection, implementation details. Part 1, Parameter and Matrices for the Universities. Overview, Summary of the Ranking Parameters, Cumulative Seats. In these cumulative seats, Teaching Learning Resources, TLR, is for the 100 marks, in which the faculty-student ratio with emphasis on the permanent faculty is the 20 marks. Combined metric for the faculty with the PhD and experience is the 30 marks. Metric for the library and the laboratory facility, 40 marks. Metric for the sport facility and the extracurricular activity, 10 marks. Research productivity, impact and IPR, RP2, 100 marks. Combined metrics of the publication, PU, 45 marks. Combined metric for the citations, 45 marks. Intellectual property rights, 10 marks. Graduation outcome, 100 marks. Combined performance in the university examination, 50 marks. Combined performance in the public examination, 50 marks. Outreach and the inclusivity, OI, 100 marks. Outreach footprint continuing education services, 25 marks. Percentage of students from the other state, country, region, diversity, 25 marks. Percentage of the women students and faculty, 25 marks. 20 marks. Percentage of the economically and socially disadvantaged students, ESDS, 20 marks. Faculty for the differently abled persons, 10 marks. Perception, 100 marks. Processes for the peer rating in the category PR, 50 marks. Application to seat ratio, 50 marks. Parameter and the matrices for the college are given separately, and these are as follow. Overview, summary of the ranking of the parameters, cumulative seat, teaching learning resources, teaching learning resources, 100 marks. Faculty student ratio with emphasis on the permanent faculty, 30 marks. Combined metric of the faculty with the PhD in experience, 30 marks. Metric for library and laboratory facility, 30 marks. Metric for sport facility and extracurricular activity, 10 marks. Research productivity, impact and IPR, 100 marks. Combined metric for the publication, 45 marks. Combined metric for the citation, 45 marks. Intellectual property right, 10 marks. Graduation outcome, 100 marks. Combined performance in university exam is the 50 marks. Combined performance in the public examination, 50 marks. Outreach and the inclusivity, OI, 100 marks. Outreach footprint, continuing education services, CES, 25 marks. Percentage of students from the other states, country, Region diversity, 25 marks. Percentage of the women students and faculty, 20 marks. Percentage of the economically and socially disadvantaged students, 20 marks. Facility for the differently abled persons, 10 marks. Perception, peer, 100 marks. Process for the peer rating in the category, peer, 50 marks. Application to seat ratio, 50 marks. These are the guidelines for the NIRF and the these are the guidelines for the executive summary. This document is the part of the National Institutional Ranking Framework with emphasis on methodology for the ranking university and colleges across the India. The methodology draws from the board understanding arrived at by the core committee CC set up by the Ministry of the Human Resource Management, MHRD, that defines broad parameters to be used for the ranking various university and institutions. The ranking parameter agreed by the core committee are the generic in nature that have been suitably adapted for evolving a detailed methodology for ranking university and the college. The main feature of the methodology suggested are as follows. It is recommended to set up a committee which will oversee the implementation of the ranking work for the first year, after which a suitable ranking agency duly authorized to receive and verify the data and declare the ranking may be set up. This document identifies a set of the suitable forms in which these parameters can be easily measured and verified across a variety of the university and the college. A strategy is suggested for calculating the scores to measure the performance of the universities and colleges across such parameters. This will help to obtain a overall score of obtaining the institution rank. Separate ranking formula for the university and colleges is suggested to ensure that the institution were compared within a appropriate peer group of the institution and provided a level playing field. A system for the data collection and the public body for the random sample checks is suggested for the each parameter. Methodology involves defining a set of the matrices for ranking of the university and colleges based on the parameters agreed upon the core committee. These parameters are organized into the five broad category that have been further grouped into the number of the subcategory. Each broad category has an overall weight assigned to it within each category. The subcategory also have an appropriate weight distribution. An attempt is made here to first identify the relevant data needed to suitably measure the performance score under each subcategory. Emphasis has been laid on identifying data that is easy to generate and easy to verify if needed in the overall interest of the transparency. A suitable matrix is then worked out based on this data, which computes a score under each subcategory. The subcategory scores is then added to obtain a score of the each individual category. The overall score is computed based on the weight allocated to each category. The overall score can take a maximum value of the 100. The institution can then be rank ordered based on their scores. Ranking based on the institutional category in view of the distinct primary mandate and objectives of the university and colleges, separate ranking is designed for these two distinct category of the institution. The university would include institutional national importance set up by the Act of the Parliament, Central University, State University, deemed to be university, private university, and other autonomous degree awarding institution. The college would include autonomous colleges that are affiliated to university and don't enjoy full academic autonomy. While score computation for some of the parameters are similar for both of these category on most of the counts, the benchmarks are somewhat different on a new parameters to take into account the ground reality, which may be very different for the two category. This also creates a level playing field for the both category. The weights assigned to the different components have been adjusted to reflect different mandates and expectations from the university and the college. Even where the assessment matrices are similar, their computation is based on their respective category. If implemented in this manner and speed, the ranking methodology will produce two separate ranking, one for university and one for college. Data collection. How the data is collected? For that, in view of the absence of the reliable and comprehensive database that could supply all relevant information required for the computing the scores for ranking, it is imperative that the university of the colleges and are desirous of the participating in the ranking exercise will be required to provide the data in the prescribed format. It is recommended that the data submitted by the university and the colleges onto NRF website should also be made available onto the publicly visible website by these institutions in the interest of the transparency. The data should remain there in an archived form from next years to enable easy cross-checking whenever required. Institutions that fail to do this honestly or resort to unethically practice should be automatically debarred from the participation in the future ranking exercise for a period of the 2 years. Their names may also be displayed on the ranking portal, indicating the nature of their unethical conduct. An attempt should also be made by the ranking authority to maintain the archived form of this data for the due diligence as needed. The ranking authority or the agency or the board should be empowered to take up a random check on the records of the institution and audited accounts to ensure that the principles of the ethical behavior are being adhered. For some of the parameters, the data should be populated from the internationally available bibliographic and the citation base, like the Scope Up, Web of Science, Indian Citation Index, and the Google Scholar. This is indicated in the assessment metric. The ranking agency should directly assess the data from these resources if necessary. Similarly, some data can be made available through a national effort. For example, data about success in the public examination can be easily compiled if all the concerned bodies, UPSC, State PSC, SSC, GATE, NET, CAT, JMAT, CMAT, etc., conducting such examination, prepare an institution-wise list, provided details of the total number of the aspirants and successful candidates from the each institution. Similarly, university, including affiliating ones, should be able to provide examination results data in appropriate format to evaluate the competence of the graduate outcomes. Implementation details. A committee should be set up to oversee the process initially till an appropriate ranking agency is established. A suitable ranking authority agency should be identified, outperformed, and empowered. The ranking should initiate invite institution intending to participate in the ranking exercise to submit their application in the prescribed format by a specified date every year through an online portal to be set up for this purpose. The ranking agency will extract the relevant data from the online portal, compute various matrices, and the rank institution. The process should be completed and ranking published before the commencement of the academic session. Part 1, parameter and the matrices for the university. Overview, university summary of the ranking parameter for the ranking university. Teaching, learning and resources, TLR 100 marks, weightage 0.30. Research, productivity, impact and IPR 100, weightage 0.40. Graduation outcome, GEO 100, weightage 0.05. Outreach and inclusivity, 100, weightage 0.15. Perception, marks 100, weightage 0.10. Teaching, learning, and resources, TLR, teacher-student ratio, and emphasis on the permanent faculty. Ranking weightage 0.30 and 25 marks. Combined metric for faculty with the PhD and experience, 25 marks. Metric for library and laboratory details, 40 marks. Metric for sports and extracurricular facility, 10 marks. Research productivity, impact, and IPR, ranking weightage 0.40, combined metric for the publication, 45 marks, combined metric for the citation, 45 marks, intellectual property right, 10 marks, graduation outcomes, ranking weightage, combined performance in the university examination, 50 marks, combined performance in the public examination, 50 marks, outreach and inclusive, ranking weightage 0.15, outreach footprint, continuing education services, 25 marks. Percentage of the students from the other state country, 25 marks. Percentage of women students and faculty, 20 marks. Percentage of economically and socially disadvantaged student, 20 marks. Facility for the differently abled person, 10 marks. Perception process for the peer rating in category, 50 marks. Ranking weightage, 0.10. Application to the seat ratio, 50 marks. Teaching, learning, and resources. And the weightage is the 0.30 overall assessment metric. Faculty student ratio with emphasis on the permanent faculty, 20 marks. This assessment will be based on the ratio of the number of the regular faculty members in the institute and total sanctioned approved intake considering all UG and the PG program. Regular appointment means the faculty on full-time basis with no time limitation their employment. However, faculty on contract basis for a period of not less than 3 years on gross salary similar to those apparent cannot also be included. Faculty member with the PhD qualification and NET and SLAT qualified with the master's degree will be counted. Visiting faculty with a PhD who are visiting the institution on a full-time basis for at least one semester can be included in count for that semester. The benchmark is set as a ratio of 1 to 15 for a scoring of the maximum mark. Assessment metric faculty student ratio will be the same for the university and college. Faculty student ratio 20, 50 into F into N, where N is the total number of the sanctioned seats in the university, considerable UG and PG program, including PhD program. F1, 0.3 into F2. F1, full-time regular faculty of all UG program in the previous year. F2, eminent teacher faculty with PhD, visiting the institution for at least a semester on a full-time basis can be counted with a count of the 0.5 for such visiting faculty for a semester in the previous year. Expected ratio 1:15 to the score the marks. For F into N, 1:50, FSR will be set to 0. Data collection from the concerned university in the prescribed format through an online interface to be developed on the NIRF website. As mentioned in the preamble, the university will be eligible for the ranking if all the relevant and updated data about the faculty member in the previous 3 years is available on the publicly visible website. The data will be achieved and also maintained by the ranking agency. Data verification by the ranking agency on a random sample basis. combined matric for faculty with the PhD and experience. Equal weightage of the 15 marks is each assigned to qualification and experience. Doctoral qualification, this parameter will be measured on the basis of the percentage of the faculty with the PhD in the relevant field. The expected benchmark would be different for the university and colleges to account for the ground DLT. Assessment metric for the university on the PhD qualification is the as follows. FQ 15 into F by 95 for F less than 95%. FQ equal to 15 for F greater than 95%. This is the formula for the calculation of the FQ. F is the percentage of the faculty with the PhD average student for the over previous 3 years implies that the benchmark is the minimum 95% to get the maximum score, decreasing the proportionally otherwise. Experience metric, experience should be normally be assessed based on the relevant experience of the faculty members. Relevance here means experience pertaining to the subject area being taught by the faculty member. More specifically, E equal to EI by F. EI denotes the experience of the ith faculty member. Denote the experience of the ith faculty member. For simplicity, however, EI may also be calculated from the age profile of the faculty members as follows. EI, AI minus 30 for AI less than 45 years. EI equal to 15, AI more than 45 years. Assessment metric for the experience. FE 15 into E by 15 or the E less than 15 years, FE equal to 15, E is greater than 50 years. E is the average years of the experience of the all faculty members as calculated above. This implies that the benchmark experience is to be 15 years to score maximum marks, decreasing proportionality otherwise. Data collection, university to submit information in a tabular form from indicating faculty name, age, qualification, indicating the university attended for the qualifying degree and experience. Updated data for the last 3 years should be available on the publicly available website and suitably archived for constancy check in the subsequent year. Data verification on a random sampling basis, combined metric for the faculty qualification and experience, FQE, FQ plus FE. Metric for the library and the laboratory facility, 40 marks. It is recommended to assign equal weight, 20 marks each to the library and laboratory facility. Laboratory facility. Library, L1 equal to 20 into percentile parameter on the basis of the annual expenditure on the library resource per student. XL1, XLIPS plus the XLIGE. XLIPS divided by N, XLIGE 2 into XL by N. XLIP, actual annual expenditure on the physical resources, books, journal, etc. XLIGE, actual in annual expenditure on the electronic resources, including electronic books, electronic journal. N is the total number of the student. If this expenditure is below the threshold value to be determined separately for each category of institution, XLI equal to 0. Laboratory, LB 20 into percentile parameter on the basis of the annual expenditure, XLB on the creation and maintenance of the laboratory resources. XLB, actual annual expenditure on creation and maintenance of the laboratory resources. If this expenditure is below a threshold value to be determined separately for each category of institution, XLB 0. Command metric for the library and the lab resources is as follows. LL, LI plus LB. LI plus LB. Matric for sports facility and extracurricular activity, SEC 10 marks. Equal weights will be given to the sport facility, sports budget, and top performance and extracurricular activity. Extracurricular activity may be typically include, but not be limited to the club, forums, NCC, NSS, etc. Parameters to be used is for sport facility, area per student, actual expenditure per student on sports, and the EC activity, number of the top position in inter-college sports, and the EC event. Each parameter to be evaluated on a percentile basis to obtain the parameter PA, PB, and PC. Weights assigned to the three components are 0.5, 0.25, and 0.25, respectively. PC, 1 if a college has at least three winners of a state or national level event. Assessment metric for the sports and extracurricular activity is as follows. Data collection to be obtained from the university. Data verification by ranking agency on a random sample basis. Research productivity, impact, and IPR. Research productivity, impact, and IPR, RP2, 100 marks. Ranking weight, 0.40. Overall assessment metric, RP2, PU plus CI plus IPR. Combined metric for the publications, PU, 45 marks. The publication indexed in the scope of Web of Science, Google Scholar, and the Indian Citation Index will be counted for assessment, and overall age value P for the previous 3 years and will be computed as the detailed letter this in them. The university will submit faculty publication list as supporting formation. However, the primary source for the information will be Scopus, Web Science, Google Scholar, and the Indian Citation Index. Books monograph should have an ISBN number and published by the reputed publisher. Assessment metric for the publication is as follows. PU is equal to 45 into the percentile parameter expressed as a function on the basis of the P by F. P is the number of the publication. Weighted average numbers given by the Scopus, Web of Science, Google Scholar, and Indian Citation Index over the previous 3 years. P equal to 0.3 into PW, 0.5 PS, 0.1 PG, 0.1 PI. PW is the number of the publication reported in the Web of the Science. PS is the number of publication reported in the Scopus. PG, number of publication reported on the Google Scholar. PI, number of publication reported in Indian Citation Index. F is the number of regular faculty numbers as used in them. Combined metric for the citation, CI, 45 marks. The assessment is to be based on the ratio of the total number of citation of the publication published in the previous 3 years. For all such publication, an average of the numbers from the four popular databases will be used. Institution will be asked to provide information in a tabular form, giving relevant details. However, the primary source will be the four citation databases, namely Scopus, Web of Science, Google Scholar, and the Indian Citation Index. Assessment metric for the citation in H follow. CI, 45 into the percentile parameter expressed as a fraction on the basis of the CC into 4, category into percentile parameter on the basis of the P. CC is the total citation count. P is the total number of publication over the period computed for the 2A. CC is the computed as follows. CC, 0.3 CCW plus 0.5 CC plus 0.1 CCG plus 0.1 CCI. Total number of citation reported on the Web of the Science. Total number of citation reported in Scopus. Total number of citation reported in the Google Scholar. Total number of citation reported in Indian Citation Index. CI equal to 45 into CC into F. Intellectual property right, 10 marks. IPR and patents granted, filed, and licensed. Marks distribution granted, 4 marks. Filed, 2 marks. Licensed, 4 marks. IPR will be broadly include information based on the patent and design for the last 3 years. Assessment method will be identified and calculation will be made as per the following formula. IPR equal to PF plus PG plus PL. Assessment of the IPR on patent, including the design file, PF equal to 2 into the percentile parameter on the basis of the PF into F. Assessment of the IPR on the patent, including the design granted. PG equal to 4 into the percentile parameter, expert as a function on the basis of the PG into F. Assessment of the IPR on patent, including the design licensed, PL equal to the 2 into IP plus 2 into percentile parameter expressed as a function on the basis of the EPF and the F. PF is the number of the patents, copyright, design filed. PG is the number of the patents, copyright, design granted, registered. PL is the number of the patent, copyright, design licensed. EP is the total earning from the patent during the last 3 years. F is the number of the permanent faculty members. IP equal to 1 if at least one patent was licensed in the previous 3 years, or at least one technology transferred during this period. IP equal to 0 otherwise. This is the formula of patent. Graduation outcome, GO 100 marks, ranking weight 0.5, overall assessment metric UE plus P. Combined performance in the university examination, UE 50 marks. Assessment in respect of the university examination will be based on the percentage of the students clearing, compiling with the degree requirement in the minimum graduation time. Data will be obtained from the university or the concerned college. Here, UE equal to university examination equal to 50 marks. For university examination, UE equal to 50 into N by 80. Here, N is the percentage of student as a fraction of those admitted through the batch average over the previous 3 years graduating in minimum time. Benchmark, at least 80% student should graduate in minimum time to score maximum marks. Data collection, UE data from the institution to be verified on a random sampling basis, but preferably directly from the university examination section. Combined performance in the public examination, P 50 marks. Assessment in respect of the public examination will be based on the cumulative percentile of the student as a fraction of the number appearing qualifying in the public examination, such as a UPSC, State PSC, SSC, GATE, NET, GATE, etc. from an institution out of the cumulative number of the successful student in that year. An effort should be made to conduct the with examination conducting agency to prepare institute-wise data. P is the public examination 50 marks. For public examination, we first calculate the percentile parameter P as follows. Let FY the fraction of the successful student from a given institution, ratio of the number of successful and the number of pairing for the examination FI. FI equal to 0 when either number of the pairing or successful candidate is nil. TI be the toughness parameter of examination I. Then the P is equal to fraction per percentile 1 minus TI into FI. Number of successful candidates in examination I. TI number of candidates appearing in examination I. Cumulative data is thus based across different examination according to their toughness index, which is measured by the ratio of the successful candidate to the total number of the pairing. P is equal to 50 into cumulative percentage of student from the institution in the cumulative data of the public examination. Data collection, P equal to data from the public service examination and the examining body. Outreach and inclusivity. Outreach inclusivity, 100 marks, ranking weight 0.5, overall assessment metric CES, RD, WS, ECS plus PCS. Outreach footprint, continuing education services, CES, 25 marks. Information to be sought from the institution regarding names and number of the refreshed orientation courses organized by the number of the participant, teacher training and related outreach activity, participant in content programs such as EPG Patshala, CEC, NME ICT, etc., interaction with the industry facilitation of the faculty in the quality improvement. Any other activity falling in this category, assessment metric CS25 into the percentile parameter based on the n equal to number of the participation certificates issued every year, averaged over previous 3 years to the teachers, industry personnel, etc., for outreach of the 6 days for the percentile parameter calculated separately for each paragraph. Percentage of students from other states, country, region diversity, 25 marks. RT equal to 18 into percentile fraction of the total student admitted, average over the past 3 years from the other state, 3 into percentile fraction of student admitted, average over past 3 years from the other country. Percentage of the woman student and the faculty, 20 marks. WS equal to 8 into N1 into 50, 8 into N2 into 20, plus 4 N3 into 2. Here, N1 and N2 are the percentage of the women student and faculty respectively. N3 is the number of the women members of the eminence as institute head or on the governing board, its own university. Benchmark, 50% women student and 20% women faculty and 2 women as institute head or in the governing board expected to score more marks. Percentage of economically and socially disadvantaged student, 20 marks. ECS 20 into N into 50. N is the percentage of the economically and the socially disadvantaged over previous 3 years. Benchmark 50% economically and socially disadvantaged student should admitted to the score maximum marks. Facility for the differently abled persons, 10 marks. DAP, the marks for the facility provided to differently abled persons are as follows. Ramps, 2 marks. Lifts, 2 marks. Walking aids, 2 marks. Disabled friendly toilets, 1.5 mark. Braille special labs, 1 mark. Audio visual aids, including the software, 1.5 marks. Perception, 100 marks. Ranking weight, 0.5. Overall assessment, 50 marks. Peer rating is to be done through a survey conducted over a large category of the academic institution head, HR heads of the employer, members of the funding agency in government, private sector, NGO, etc. List of the university may be obtained and a comprehensive list may be prepared taking into account various sector, regions, etc., which may be circulated periodically. Online survey may be carried out in a time-bound fashion involving the faculty, student, and other stakeholders. Application to be SRET ratio, SR, 50 marks. Application to SRET ratio will be based on the ratio of the number of students applying for a course and total sanctioned approved intake. Considering all the UG and PG program, data will be obtained from the university or the concerned college. Assessment metric will be the same for the university and colleges and will be calculated individually for the each category. SR 50 R by R, R equal to A by S. R is the maximum value of R in consider set of the institution. S is the total number of the sanctioned approved intake of the institution considering all UG and the PG program. A is equal to total number of application received in institution considering all the UG and the PG program.